have honorees for the night for their inductions. And I'm Micheal's older brother, not the bigger brother, but just the older brother. And Micheal, he's here with his lovely wife, Trina, and three of his four daughters are here who I love to death. Micheal's the youngest of 13 siblings. I'm number 12. I'll let you know, out of 13, we had to endure some things. We got, you know, six older brothers, so, you know, that kind of got a little rough around the house. Back then, you know, I didn't know whether having a baby brother was a blessing or a curse. I mean, because me and Mike, we would argue about anything. I mean, from socks to, we had a little moped we had to share with the mom brought us. We would argue, I mean, from sun up to sundown about it. So I didn't know whether, you know, it was a blessing or a curse. I had the opportunity to watch him develop from a small kid. When we used to go out in the yard and we used to play, you know, tackle man with football. But later on in life, you know, as he started to mature and get bigger, then I watched him become a punishing hitter on whoever the bandit had the ball. And trust me, it was a hard hitting going on there. As it, during his senior year, he wasn't able to play much because he tore up his ankle playing basketball. He was in the gym, you know, he was an athlete trying to, you know, dunk the ball, and he ended up tearing up his ankle. But that didn't stop him from doing what he wanted to do. His sophomore and junior year, he had made enough buzz around the town that he had the college coaches come knocking at the door. And senior year, like I said, he might have played maybe a couple games, but still yet, he excelled enough that he had the college coaches offer him full scholarship. So he didn't miss a beat on any of that. But what I can tell you, what I like most about my brother, what I admire most about my brother, is by him being a dad to his four daughters, or him being on the field making a big hit, or him receiving awards, from being a businessman, managing his own company, or volunteering his time to teach other young kids the right way to play the game. He might be my youngest brother, but he made the biggest impact on me. I used to always tell Mike, when I grow up, I want to be like you. I'm just a year older than him. But he's a God-fearing man. He loved his wife, he loved his family, he loved his friends. And I would like to thank him for being my little brother. He's my best friend. And as I stand here now reminiscing about the past, I can only say that it definitely wasn't a curse. He was definitely a blessing to me and our family. So it gives me great pleasure and honor to introduce the song and present to others my baby brother, Mr. Micheal Dean Perry.
Somebody 200 pounds is doing, had to go a little crazy anyway.
think that you can do it. But I'm glad to be inducted to the South Carolina Football Hall of Fame. It's a very small fraternity. And when I got the call and said, "You've been inducted," right away I start reminiscing. And I start thinking about my career, high school, college, and the pros. Thought about games, good games I had, bad games I had. And so, after I went through that process, I said, what did you miss the most? And the one thing that I wish I had was more time. I wish I had more time. Because we always say, yeah, when I talk all the time, we talk about our childhood. Man, you remember when? Yeah, we did this, we did that. It's like, man, those were good things. High school, college, pros. I wish I had more time. As I look at my family, three of my girls, Taylor, Tyra, Tierra, stand up, my beautiful daughters.
Absolutely right. I wish I had more time.
because I know you guys have heard about CTE, brain injury that a lot of the guys have. And I'm not dying, trust me. At least I'm regular dying. So anyway, I went to Florida, got evaluated, and I was talking to the doctor. And he said, well, what did you find? He said, well, you know, most professional athletes who play for a long time, they have some symptoms. How severe they are, how much they have progress, don't know right away. It's only time will tell. And for a long time, I thought that my biggest concern was, when I'm 65 years old, 70, will I be able to walk? Will I have good health? But when I went and got evaluated, and he was talking about this disease, I started thinking, kind of threw me back for a minute. Mentally, I was taken back. Because it goes back to that age-old question. Do you rather have health or wealth? And I can honestly say, a guy that grew up in Aiken, South Carolina, with 13 brothers and sisters, mother was a cook at school, my father painted houses for it, so you know we didn't have much resources. So I experienced one end of the spectrum to the other. So when he told me about the condition, I talked to my wife, she said, just because you got no, that don't mean it's going to happen. Yes, we have unwavering faith. But the mind automatically takes you back and you start thinking, how much time do I have now? That's why I posed the question when I first came to it, that I wish I had more time. Because really and truly, you never know. And really, I will try to make the best of my time, regardless of what the diagnosis, what happens. I will enjoy my time here and the people that I love. I want to thank the South Carolina Football Hall of Fame for honoring me, the other inductees, players of the year, and God bless you. Thank you very much.